En question.
Le président. Allez vous asseoir.
President, please be seated.
En je me dis bien. OK, on va
The court is back in session. The chamber now hands over the floor to the defense teams for the accused, starting first from the defense team for Mr. Nunjia to put questions to this witness.
You may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Your Honor's counsel. Good afternoon, Mr. Witness. I have some questions that I would like to put to you today. First, I would like to ask you some questions about Moon. Earlier this morning, you said that you yourself had not witnessed any killing of people in the pagoda, that you had heard this from Moon. Would it be correct if I say that if it wasn't for Moon, you would not have any knowledge as to the question whether the Cham people were killed inside of this Wat?
De l'exécution de Cham dans ce Wat.
President, please hold on, Mr. Witness. You may now proceed. International Deputy Co-Prosecutor.
I think asking him if is a hypothetical question that's asking the witness to speculate.
I'm not sure if I understand the objection.
I'm
just trying to establish whether his knowledge of the alleged killing of Cham in Wat-Rotokoun is only coming from Moon. In other words, the other way around, if it weren't for Moon, he wouldn't know that these Cham that he had co-arrested had been killed. I think that is a fair question.
Les Cham qu'il avait, à l'arrestation desquels il avait participé, n'auraient pas été exécutés. Il n'avait pas su qu'ils étaient exécutés.
Witness, I would like to tell you, Mr. Counsel.
Le témoin.
I learned the information
je tiens à vous dire.
From the truth. It is not my imagination, or it's not the information that I learned from nowhere. Moon and I was a close friend.
Moon était un ami proche.
Knew each other for quite a long time at Otakun Pagoda. From what I heard, Moon was engaging in the killing of Cham people because he was one member within the security guard unit.
Car il était membre de l'unité de garde de
sécurité. He in fact attended the killing.
Il était là.
He did not tell me, in an open manner. He told me secretly that he was one of the members within the security guard unit. He told me at that time in relation to this matter, he told me many things. I can spend 2 days to tell you about the Khmer Rouge time that I, this information I learned, some I learned from him.
Certaines informations, je les ai obtenues de lui.
Regarding other matters, I may have forgotten because of our memory. I cannot recall everything. For example, if I at a type of dish 10 days ago, I would not have remembered what I had 10 days ago. So what the people said, some are true, because I saw, at the time I saw young people arriving at the village, and for young children, young babies, they could not climb up the stairs, and they were thrown or pushed up into the temple at that time. So this is what I can tell you.
I understand what you're saying, Mr. Witness, but we are in a court of law, and what I'm trying to find out is what exactly your source of knowledge is in relation to the actual alleged killing of Cham. You said again it was Moon who told you. Is there any other source of information that would corroborate Moon's telling you of what happened? Anything else other than Moon?
À part Moon.
Yeah. We have answer that there are many sources of information I have learned from
de
the cook or the chefs within the compound of the security guard unit. That cook was close to my mother-in-law.
He was the
godson of my mother-in-law. He would tell my mother-in-law secretly about some things happened within the pagoda. The information leaked out to the villagers or public at that time, he would have been killed. Some people did dare to confide things to other people after the end of the regime in 1979. Some people who had known the security guards at the Outer Kun pagoda confided to other villagers in the country.
Parler à d'autres villageois.
So the information that I learned from other people after 1979 corroborated with what Moon had told me.
De différentes sources, des informations qui ont corroboré.
What you're exactly saying, what the problem is, Mr. Witness, that is post 79 information.
Ce sont des
what I'm interested in is finding sources of information who, like you said, Moon, were also witnesses. So my question is, let me start with the cook, for instance. Do you know what's the name of the cook? Do you know what he has seen? And to whom did he tell?
À qui en a-t-il parlé?
Answer. The cook, the female, not the male.
C'est une femme.
I do not know her name.
Je ne connais pas son nom.
The cook's name was Comrade Min.
Le cuisinier,
at the security guard complex. That person was the guard daughter of my mother-in-law.
Était donc la filleule.
Sometimes my mother-in-law and the cook would spend time together. And she confided things to my mother-in-law and warned my mother-in-law not to reveal what she had told my mother-in-law. Otherwise, that cook would be arrested by the guards.
And did this cook confide in your godmother-in-law, mother-in-law? At the time when it happened in 77 or after 79?
Ou après 79. Réponse.
Answer. Regarding the cook, after 1979, she confided things in my mother-in-law, and she also confided things
Elle lui a aussi dit certaines choses
in my mother-in-law in the regime. Yad was also another cook.
She's
alive until today, and she may have known about what happened at the Otakon Pagoda.
And are they still alive today?
Question. Sont-ils toujours vivants? Réponse.
Regarding Win, I have no idea whether she's still alive or not. However, Yat, she is living currently
est toujours en vie.
At Pretobo village,
dans le district de Trey Santo.
She is living at the moment.
Elle est toujours. Question.
When Moon told you what had happened with the charm,
quand Moon
that you said you helped arrest.
Ce qui était arrivé au Cham, que vous aviez aidé à arrêter.
Did you tell your wife what you had heard from Moon?
Vous avez-vous répété à votre épouse
the same day or the next day?
Vous avez dit le jour même ou le lendemain peut-être.
Answer.
Réponse.
Moon told me, confided in me. We,
Moon,
for example, as a husband and wife, I have told my wife that Cham people who had been arrested the other day were all killed. In fact, Cham people were killed on that night. I can vouch for this information that those Cham people had been killed during the night. Although I did not witness the incident, I can vouch for that fact that they were all killed, and I learned from Moon about rapes of Cham women and also rape of new people, those women were strapped off their clothes and wrapped afterwards. So I learned almost everything from Muen and from. I learned everything from Muen. So as I said earlier, I can spend 2 days to elaborate and describe all what happened in the regime to you.
But my question was, Mr. Witness, when Muen told you something, did you then subsequently tell your wife about what Moon had told you? Something like, what Moon told me this or Moon told me that? At the same, at around the same time. Do you remember any of this?
Et à peu près au même moment, à la même époque. Vous en souvenez-vous?
Answer. As I told you, generally speaking, we as wife and husband confide in each other because some Cham people were working with my wife during that period, and after those Cham people had been arrested, I also told my wife about rest of Cham people, for example, Matt. Who was arrested, and my wife asked me how could I learn the information, and I told her that Muen, my colleague who was a security guard, told me about that incident. Sometime I was invited inside the temple, but I did not dare to go inside. I only met Moon, you know, at the outside compound of that pagoda.
J'ai rencontré Moon à l'extérieur de l'enceinte.
I will ask it very simply.
Maître Coppé, je vais poser la question le plus simplement possible.
Quand Cham people had been killed, did you then subsequently, the same day or the next day, tell your wife?
Le lendemain, en avez-vous parlé à votre épouse?
After the event of killing, I would tell my wife about that incident. Usually, I learned about the killing the next day. And I would tell my wife that Jam people had been killed the previous day.
Je l'ai su le lendemain. For example, donc, j'ai dit à mon épouse que des Jam avaient été tués la
veille. My wife, that mom, and him, son or daughter, could flee the killing.
De mam et plie.
Matt and the other individual had not yet married with one
Matt
another. They fled at that time. They were engaged already.
Ils avaient déjà été fiancés.
Jam people were also living in the Angkor Ban, and these people were taken into the pagoda and killed. I cannot tell you how many Jam people living in Angkor Ban, but I could say there were many of them.
Is your wife still alive, Mr. Witness?
Votre épouse est-elle toujours vivante?
Answer. She passed away in 1981.
Do you know whether Moon only told you, or did Moon also tell others as to things that he said he saw?
Au sujet de ces choses qu'il dit avoir vu. Réponse.
Answer. I do not know whether Moon told others about
si
the events. Although he confided things in others people, I would not have known.
S'il s'est confié à d'autres
regarding
personnes, je ne le sais pas.
My relationship and Moon, I at one time was talking to Moon, but not in an open atmosphere,
Moon,
secretly,
pas ouvertement. C'était
I would say.
Earlier, Mr. Witness, you were asked by the prosecution about the alleged number of people being killed, and you were asked about a figure
of personnes tuées, vous,
corpses
vous
that had been found in pits, and a number of 30,000 was mentioned.
Dans des fosses, on
and then you said, well, that is exaggerated, I think,
were
15,000. Did I summarize that correctly?
Answer. Regarding the people who had been taken away and killed, based on the documents at the stupa, the figure
d'après les
was
que l'on retrouve sur le stupa,
written down as 30,000.
Le chiffre qui a été inscrit sur le stupa, c'est 30 000.
35,000.
35 000.
Rather.
Plutôt.
During the time after 1979, I was about 30 years old. And as I told you earlier, we human beings have to tell the truth, tell of what that we have seen and heard.
Ce que nous avons vu, ce que nous avons entendu.
I have been living in the in my village. I was engaged in
j'ai
the research and also writing down what happened in the regime. Yes, I noticed the figure of 35,000 was mentioned, but I do not know how that figure came into the document.
It is
their right to agree with which figure.
C'est leur droit de
to my estimates, the people who died at that time may be, you know, around 20,000 or a bit lower than that.
Well, we might get back to that one. Let me read to you your interview notes, or your interview, sorry, with the prosecution, E3/5302. And more particularly, the excerpt from English ERN, page 0021-0489, Khmer 00635178, and French 00623192. And here you say, quote, Moon told me in 78 that approximately 30,000 people had been killed at Outra Kun, unquote. So it seems that the information about 30,000 people is coming from that same moon. Is that correct?
That's exact.
Answer. Reports. Regarding the figure Moon told me, he never told me about the figure of 20,000 or 30,000.
Moon ne m'a jamais parlé de 20,000 ou 30,000.
Had never told me about the figure. The figure. The, I learned the figure from the wall at the stupa,
and sur le mur,
I heard the, about the figure from one another that the people dead could reach the number of 30 or 35,000. There was no, you know, accurate document stating about the figure, and it is the estimates from everyone.
I was quoting you from a document which is in this room. A bit unusual. It's interview notes from the prosecution, and I don't really see any explanation of how it went. But it says here that it was Moon who told you. You said that approximately 30,000 people had been killed at Wat Ultrakun. So that's not correct. Moon never said that to you in 78.
Moon ne vous a jamais dit cela en 78.
Answer. In 1978, Moon and I did not discuss the figure as stated. I did not communicate with Moon about the figure or about the number of people who had been killed, but we actually talked to each other about the killing. I never discussed with Moon about the figure.
Je n'ai jamais parlé du nombre de personnes tuées, comme il est suggéré dans ce document. Avec
Now let us talk a little bit about Moon.
Parlons de Moon, justement.
You said he was himself involved in killing.
Lui-même a participé aux exécutions.
Was he also himself involved in the killing of those Cham?
A-t-il participé à l'exécution de ces Cham?
Answer. Regarding the discussion of the killing of Cham people, Nguyen was also engaged in the killing of Cham people and also the new people and the 17 April people. He was the one who was engaged in the killing of those people.
But it was my understanding that Moon was a palm tree climber like you. Is that correct?
S'occupait des palmiers comme vous. N'est-ce pas le cas? Réponse.
Answer. Yes.
Oui, oui.
He was the climber of the sugar palm tree. Usually, his work was at night time, not during the daytime.
Travail, c'était le soir, pas le
Sir, can you explain
question.
To me, or did he tell you maybe, how he is a, I suppose, ordinary palm tree climber became one of the major killers of of the pagoda?
Est devenu un des plus grands bourreaux de la pagode. Réponse.
Answer. Let me clarify for you, Mr. Counsel. During Pol Pot time, everyone, including me, had a different task to do. Sometimes I was assigned to go fishing, and on some other occasion, I was asked to go and grow vegetables or climb the sugar palm trees. Moon was part of the security guard unit. However, he knew how to make the palm sugar.
Mais il savait aussi faire
so,
du sucre de palme.
He was assigned to climb up
Donc,
the sugar palm tree at night time and during the daytime. His
jour,
assignment was a security guard at
il était garde de sécurité.
Otokun Pagoda. Because he knew how to climb up the
Car
sugar palm trees, he received additional assignment on top
donc,
of security guard
tasks. En plus de son de ses fonctions en tant que garde de sécurité.
And sometimes he was assigned to bring in the people into the
fois,
temple or
brought
the people to certain places. So once again, I would like to correct. Muyen was assigned to, you know, to climb up the palm sugar palm tree and also to
palmier,
work as a guard.
Mais aussi affecté à la garde. Question.
But a guard is something else than somebody who is actually doing killing.
Un garde,
so was he, in addition to a palm tree climber? Not only a guard, but also a killer. Is that what you're saying?
Vous dites qu'en plus de s'occuper des palmiers et d'être un garde, il est aussi un tueur. Le président.
President, please wait, Mr. Whitney. You may not proceed. Deputy co-prosecutor.
I think this question is leading. Security guards have multiple tasks. They didn't have the position titled killer at these security offices. So I think counsel's question is misstating the evidence.
I'm not sure that we had any evidence already on this, what Otrokun, Mr. President. He's the first witness, I think, to actually speak about it, at least about who was inside. So I think. My question is fair, but I will rephrase. Is it your testimony, Mr. Witness, that Moon was not only a palm tree climber, a security guard, but also a security guard who killed people?
Answer, yes.
Oui.
Muel was not only palm tree climber. At first, he was a member within security guard unit at Otokun Pagoda. During the regime, one who knew about how to fish, he or she would be assigned to go fishing, and this individual would be reassigned back to normal tasks at night time. This applies to everyone during that time. Security guards' eyes were red, were usually red because they drink the wine
étaient rouges car ils
with the gallbladder inside.
Avec de la vésicule biliaire
and for those who did not know, security guards or Muen may have felt afraid of them because their eyes looked rather red.
Did Moon's own eyes look red when he told you things?
Moon avait-il lui-même les yeux rouges quand il vous a parlé de tout ça?
Yes, his eyes looked rather red, like a drunkard.
Il avait les yeux plutôt rouges, comme s'il avait bu.
Because I knew him, I felt okay. And but if I did not know Muen, I would have felt afraid of him because of his facial expression and eyes.
Do you remember whether Moon was always drunk or only sometimes?
Vous si Moon était tout le temps sous ou seulement parfois?
No, he was not drunk. However, his eyes
cependant, ses yeux
looked red, and his eyes were different from ours.
Ses yeux étaient différents des nôtres.
And at one point, he asked me whether I knew and wanted to drink
a wine, which was made
from pure wine mixed with the German gallbladder. However, he mentioned it to me secretly, not in public.
Just to be sure, the red eyes of Moon was because he drank too much palm juice. Is that my understanding?
It is very difficult for me to explain to you about the apparent red eyes look. Because I did not drink. However, people who involved in the killing were encouraged to drink my wine mixed with German gallbladder so that they would feel brave.
Is my understanding correct that there were two other members in the palm tree climbing unit?
Dans l'unité chargée de grimper au palmier à sucre.
Among the members, the four main group
les membres
of palm tree climbing, all are still alive.
Le groupe de quatre personnes, bien toutes les personnes
and
sont encore en vie.
Did Moon only confide in you, or did he also confide in the other two palm tree climb unit members?
Aux deux autres membres de l'unité chargée de monter au palmier.
I do not know whether he spoke to the other members.
Réponse, je ne sais pas s'il parlait aux deux
autres. However, the other climbers did not climb the palm trees
ne montaient pas
around the compound
palmier,
of the pagoda.
I
was assigned to climb five palm trees situated at the vicinity of the pagoda compound, while others were assigned to climb at the palm trees far.
De monter au sommet de palmier
from
qui se
the
loin
pagoda compound
de l'enceinte de la pagode.
And as for Moon was assigned to climb a separate row of palm trees not far from where I climbed. And in fact, the trees that Moon climbed was the one that I used to climb before, but they requested to have three palm trees for the people working within the premises of the pagoda. And actually, my unit chief agreed to give those three palm trees to the security forces.
Were the other two members of your palm tree climbing unit also at the same time security guards? Or was only Moon a security guard?
As for the other climbers, the president interrupts, and the deputy co-prosecutor, do you have the floor?
Yes, Mr. President, I don't think counsel has asked this, and I think he's making an assumption based on his interview. Moon was not considered one of the four members of his unit. He identifies the other three members, so I think the assumption that counsel is making is incorrect, and perhaps he should clarify that with the witness, that Moon was part of the four-person climbing unit that the witness has talked about.
I think I wrote that down, actually, as his testimony today, but I'm happy to verify. Mr. Witness, you spoke about a palm tree unit of four men, you, two others, and was the fourth one Moon himself?
I have actually stated that Moon was part of the security force, but for us, the civilians, there were four of us in a team who were assigned to climb the palm trees, and we did not involve in any of the security work. And Moon, he was a palm tree climber within the security force, separate from us, the civilian group. As I said, I was a civilian and I did not work for the security force.
Okay, I understand now. Were there other palm tree units in addition to your unit of four?
Votre propre unité constituée de quatre personnes.
Yes, there were.
Réponse.
However,
oui, cependant,
in my Sambomirko or Sambomirke village, it was divided into two, the upper part and the lower part. And I was part of the lower Sambomir village. And there was another palm tree climbing unit within the upper part of the Sambomir village. And that team composed of 3 to 4 men as well. But they climbed different palm trees, and the palm trees that they climbed were about 500 meters from where we climbed.
And do you know whether Moon confided in those other palm tree climbers as to what happened at Wat Outrakoun?
Il leur révélait ce qu'il se passait à Outrakoun.
President, witness, you do not need to respond to this. It is repetitive, and you have responded at least twice.
I was talking about another unit, Mr. President. I will move on.
President, witness, you do not need to respond to that question since it is repetitive.
Okay. One last question on this topic, then. Mr. Witness, can you explain why it was you of the palm tree climbers that Moon confided in?
Pourquoi Moon vous avez choisi pour être son confident parmi tous les membres de l'équipe chargée de grimper au palmier?
Allow me to clarify the matter.
Réponse.
Moon told me those things, and where we worked, nobody, no civilians were allowed to trespass. For that reason, Moon spoke to me.
C'est pourquoi Moon me parlait à moi.
No civilians were allowed to trespass the area, and some villagers did not even dare to walk within that vicinity.
À proximité de cet endroit.
And as I said, he spoke to me
comme
because I climbed palm trees not far from where he climbed. And usually, sometimes when we rested, then we chit-chatted.
Et lorsque nous nous reposions, parfois nous bavardions.
And sometimes I wanted to know what was going on inside,
and I asked him questions. Alors je lui posais des questions.
And because we were friends, he
amis,
would not mind me asking him questions,
ça ne le dérangeait pas que je
but allow me
questions.
To clarify, I never entered or involved with the security affairs. Even sometimes Moon asked me to enter the compound, but I did not dare to enter.
Was Moon ever arrested himself or detained himself for a while?
L'intervention a commencé hors micro et l'interprète n'a pas saisi les questions.
Moon was not arrested.
He was part of the
district security force
since he was in Kiao village.
As for some ordinary members of the mobile of the security force, like Moon, they were not a subject of killing. Only the chiefs were arrested and killed, but the ordinary members were not the target. And that happened also at the commune level. The chief of the Sangkat, or the chief of the commune, was arrested and killed, but militia members were not killed, and later on they were used.
Let me now go back to that day of the arrest of the many Cham. Did Moon tell you who was involved in the killing besides himself? Did he give you any names of fellow security people who were involved in the alleged killing?
D'autres membres de la sécurité qui auraient été impliqués dans les exécutions.
I think I responded to this kind of question already. It was not the security force who actually went out to make the arrest. It was actually the long sword group which was established in 1977 and who themselves are directly involved in going out and arresting the people. As for the security force, they were at the base or at the detention center to receive and to detain those people. The long sword group members were the ones who actually made the arrest.
Maybe something went
wrong in the translation, Mr. Witness, but my question was, did Moon tell you the names of the people who were involved in the killing, not the arrest, but the killing of Cham? You said Moon was involved, but did Moon tell you who else participated?
I can respond to part of your question.
Je peux répondre à une partie de votre question.
There were many members of the security forces involved
in the event. Il y avait bon nombre de membres des forces de sécurité qui étaient impliqués dans cet événement. Certains membres étaient jeunes,
15 years old or 20 years old.
Ou une vingtaine d'années.
As for the executioners, they were actually competing one amongst one another.
If
they killed more, then they would be selected to be in charge of a unit, for instance. And there was a case that I heard that within an hour, one young member who was about 20 years old actually killed 70 people, and that was the record. And the killing took place inside the pagoda compound and along the main road. And for those who killed people along the main road were pretty young.
They were 15
years old, for example, and when they were carrying guns, the gun nozzles actually touched the ground.
Leurs armes étaient touchées le sol tant ils étaient jeunes.
As for the security force members,
ce qui concerne les membres
I
knew
Moon and Bot and another one at the Breakabai village, but I cannot recall the name.
Je ne me souviens pas de son nom.
Bot was deputy of Horn, but Bot later on he was arrested and killed by Horn.
Par la suite tué par Horn.
And rather, Bot was assigned to replace Horn later on, and he was spared his life so that he could provide statistics of the residents in the area. And after Kun, the security chief was killed.
Le chef de sécurité a été tué.
Bot was killed, Bot and I asked Moon about the killing of Bot, and
j'ai posé la question
he said
à Moon au sujet
Horn
de Bon, il a répondu
had
que Horn
an a love affair with a woman who was a daughter of a former minister. And actually, I saw her; she was
en fait,
beautiful.
Elle était très belle.
Da was a younger brother of that woman, and she had another sister by the name of Daet.
Une sœur aînée du nom de Daet.
And they were all nice looking, and the three
et
had been arrested and brought to Otakun Pagoda, and both fell in love with that woman. And Horn knew about it, since Horn also fell in love with the same woman, so Horn killed Bot.
C'est pourquoi Horn a tué Bot.
And as I told you, Bot and Moon were the
Bot
two members of the security force that I knew, and I did not know the rest, and some of them were pretty young.
Certains étaient très
as
jeunes.
I said, some of them were
dit,
competing to kill more people per hour, and one reached a record of killing 70 people in an hour.
I know, Mr. Witness, you have been telling the story before to the investigators, your sole source of this being Moon. But did Moon give you names of security guards other than Bot who are still alive today and who could potentially confirm what Moon has described?
Moon did not tell me about the names of those killers.
Moon ne m'a pas donné le nom de ces exécutifs.
Let me ask the question a bit broader, Mr. Witness. Did Moon give you any names of anybody who worked in Wat Otrakun who are still alive today and who could potentially confirm what Moon said he saw that night?
As for the killers who were members of the security force at the Otrakun,
qui faisaient partie des forces de sécurité à Otrakun,
I cannot say whether they are still alive or not, because when the regime fell, they all ran back to their native villages.
Est tombé, ils sont tous
and as for the names, as I just told you, I do not know their names.
Je ne connais pas leur nom.
And during the regime, they did not actually use their real names. They used aliases.
Ils utilisaient des
for example, Tatoj.
Tatoj
was an alias for Koytun, and nobody knew Koytun was. This is just an example
Koytun.
For
voilà
you. And if I were to know their real names, then I probably could know where they are,
si
if they are still alive.
Nom, alors je saurais peut-être où ils se trouvent aujourd'hui.
Very well, I will move on to another topic now, Mr. Witness. You said you were involved in the arrest of the Cham from your commune. I'm not sure if I understand why you were asked to assist in the arrest. Did they tell you why? Were they, for instance, short of manpower? What was it that made cadres decide to ask you to help?
As for the rest of the Cham people, I did not involved in the arrest.
Je n'ai pas
I did not even know why I was assigned to
pourquoi.
Go with them.
On
at that time, they said
eux.
You, the climbers group,
toi.
had to go to the main road.
Aller à la route principale.
And only after the Cham people were arrested and brought to the main road, then I realized that they were being arrested, and they were being arrested by members of the Longsword group. And I was there to guard them and not to allow them to enter the main road. And they were there at the north part of the road, and their direction was to gather all those Cham people and lead them to the Otrokun pagoda. I was rather surprised, and my tea almost fell because I was so pity for the Cham people. They did not realize that they were the subject of the arrest.
Ils ne savaient pas qu'ils étaient en train d'être arrêtés.
And some of them were arrested while they were having dinner or while
certains
they were having a bath.
Arrêtés alors qu'ils prenaient leur bain, d'autres
they did not even have a chance to change their dirty clothes
when
they were
pas
arrested.
Eu le temps de
and I witnessed that, but I did not involved in the arrest.
J'en ai été témoin, mais je n'ai
and
pas
of course,
pris part
at that time, we as civilians, if we were instructed to go and do anything, we would follow their instructions. But personally, if I was ordered to kill people,
mais
no,
si
I would not do it.
But
at that time, I was ordered to stand guard of those
Cham
people who had been arrested.
Did you have a gun at the time?
Of course not. I was barehand. I was not even allowed to carry a knife that I used to climb the palm tree. So I went along with them to the main road with my bare hands, and we were rather wondering why we were being asked to go with them to the main road, as they didn't tell us that they were going to conduct the arrest of the Cham people at all.
You're actually asking my question already, Mr. Witness, because I was asking myself the same thing. Why did they need you? You didn't have a gun, you weren't instructed. What were you doing? What were you told to do?
In the regime, people were so afraid of the authority. Even the members of the Longsword group didn't carry any weapons. They had swords and knives. And if the Cham people were to unite together, the situation could be different.
La situation aurait peut-être été différente.
Even I myself, if I was ordered to raise my hand for them to tie them up, then I would do the same. We just feel so afraid of them.
Moi-même, si on m'avait demandé,
and
nous,
those
je
people
fait
did
de même.
Not
nous
carry weapons, but they had
peur.
Swords.
Les gens n'avaient pas de,
but what were you asked to do? What did you do?
Question, mais que vous a-t-on demandé de faire? Qu'avez-vous fait?
Did you
I did not do anything. I was standing there. I was told, comrade, you stand there. And I asked him back, why? And he said, just stand there to watch and not allow the Cham people to run through the riverside. But none of the Cham attempted to run. And when they were instructed to walk, they just simply walked. By that time, if some of them were to flee, then they would be successful, as the night was about to get dark, and the security force members were actually leading them, and I was walking behind, and in the middle part of the queue, nobody guarded them, and if some of them decided to flee, they would be successful, but none ever attempted to do so.
And what were you doing? You were just walking along with the group? Or did you do something?
I have responded repeatedly.
Réponse, mais j'ai déjà répondu maintes fois.
That I was not involved in any other matters besides climbing palm trees and fishing. I did not involve in that regime of genocide.
Je n'ai rien eu à voir avec le régime, le génocide.
Generally speaking, during the Khmer Rouge regime, if you knew how to read, you would not be used by the regime authority. They only used those illiterate people. And at that time, I was considered a student who was knowledgeable, so I was not used.
Que j'étais comme un étudiant qui savait et donc je ne pouvais pas utiliser.
Now that you mention it,
question. Maintenant,
what was your the position of your father after 1979? Was he involved in setting up the memorial site and the stupa, etc.?
A-t-il participé à la création du mémorial et du stupa?
From 1979, my father did not have any real position, but he liked gathering those skeleton remains and took care of schools. And that was what he did.
Fine, I'll get back to that. You said that the men of the group were handcuffed.
Vous avez dit que les
who was it that did that? Who cuffed
menotté.
The men of that group?
Qui a menotté les hommes de ce groupe?
I did not say that those arrested were handcuffed. What I said was that those detainees in the temple were shackled. The Cham people who were arrested and before they were ordered to enter the temple compound, the men were beaten once with a metal bar. As for the Cham women, they were not beaten. And that's what I saw. As for the Cham young children who could not walk up the stairs, they were thrown or pushed into the temple. And once they were in the temple, their ankles were shackled and they were not cuffed at all. There were no handcuffs. However, there were shackles and the shackles were used and people were detained in a shackle in a row of 30 to 40.
So, is my understanding correct then that before the whole group went into the temple, nobody was cuffed.
Dans le temple, personne n'était menotté, demande Maître Coupin.
Khlong chamnao bong paon Islam tong oh nung
dai ki pchuon ta wat nung ot mien ban na nam mu de pagoda non was tied up or handcuffed. They simply followed those people. They simply walked and followed them.
Ils ont simplement suivi. Ils se sont suivis les autres.
You said that when the men entered the temple,
question.
Each and one of them were beaten by with a metal bar.
Temple,
is that correct?
Chacun d'entre eux a été battu à coups de barre de fer. C'est exact.
Yes, and that's what I saw before the men were ordered to enter the temple. Each one of them was beaten with a metal bar. Only the men were beaten, not the young children.
Seulement eux, pas les jeunes.
And when the first man was beaten, did the other Cham men see that just like you? Were they able to observe this beating as well?
Comme vous? Réponse.
When all of the Chan people entered the pagoda compound, they were surrounded by the security force members.
Quand ils sont entrés dans l'enceinte de la pagode, ils étaient encerclés.
And for that reason, none of them could escape.
C'est pourquoi personne d'autre ne pouvait s'enfuir.
The Chan people who were behind the queue of the man, or the one who was beaten, saw what happened, but none reacted. As for Chan women, they were not beaten, and they were pushed inside the temple. There was no proper lighting. There was only kerosene lamp.
Tout simplement des lampes de kérosène.
Let me go back to the beginning of their arrests.
Question. J'aimerais en revenir au début de ces arrestations.
Is it correct when I say to you that if the women or children had decided not to follow their respective men, they wouldn't have been arrested? In other words, only the men were arrested and the women and children as well, but only because they followed their men?
Les femmes et les enfants l'ont été aussi simplement parce qu'ils ont suivi les hommes.
Answer. It is true, when after her husband had been arrested, family members would also be arrêté, arrested. Women were too weak to resist. During Pol Pot time, there was not enough food for everyone to eat, so we were weak in terms of our physical strength. We went to work because we were all afraid of being killed.
Et nous allions tous travailler car nous avions
since
peur
we were
d'être
weak,
tués.
We were not able to
affaiblis.
Resist them.
We were
skinny and we had big kneecaps. Whenever we had a fish, we would be very happy.
My question was concrete.
Do you know of
men being arrested that day who were not followed by their wives or children?
Et dont les femmes et les enfants ne les ont pas suivis.
Answer. No, when there were arrests made, the whole family members were also arrested together with the spouse or the husband. The older Cham people in the families were also arrested.
On a aussi arrêté les Cham plus âgés.
Can you give us one name of Cham men?
Le nom d'un homme.
Who you saw was arrested?
D'un Cham, dont vous avez été témoin de l'arrestation.
Answer, yes,
réponse.
I can give you some names,
je peux vous donner des noms.
But many of them passed away already. I know many names.
Je connais beaucoup de noms.
Since some of them had passed away already, I don't
Mais
think it has been beneficial for you to get a name.
Jukman
were among the fisher folks during the regime. And for Cham people, the name Man were used
Man
by different Cham people
Cham
within the village. So there was not only Man, there were many Man. Jin, Rin, Man, they were all members within the fish folk. It has been 20 or 30 years
20 ou 30 ans
from that time, so I think it's very difficult to locate, identify those people.
De
even our friends who have been away from us for 20 days, we would have, you know, not remember all of them.
Let me ask the question differently. Can you give me one name of a charm man who you saw in that group, together with the name of his wife and his possible children? Can you describe one family to me?
Answer, yes. I can tell you one name, the Jam husband who had been arrested. I do not know the wife's name.
Mok.
And there was also an individual by the name Rin, the head of the family.
Let's start with Rin.
Commençons avec Rin.
Was Rin the same family as Mok, you said?
Rin était dans la même famille que
Mok. Two different families.
Ou parlez-vous de deux familles différentes?
Clem.
Réponse.
Not Mok.
Pas
I
Mok.
Did not say Mok.
Je n'ai pas dit Mok.
Let's start with Rin.
Question.
Did you see
Rin
walking in that group?
Avez-vous Rin dans ce groupe?
Answer. When Jam people had been arrested, I noticed he was in the group.
Quand
my house was close to his.
Ma maison était proche de la sienne.
And after Jam people had been arrested and placed in the groups, he was among the group. And I did not know exactly where he was at that time.
Je ne sais pas
exactement
où il était.
As I told you, his house was close to Khmer people's house at that time.
Sa maison était proche de celle des Khmer.
Was Rin accompanied by his wife and his children?
Était-il accompagné de sa femme et de ses enfants?
Answer. I have told
Réponse.
You repeatedly.
Je m'évertue à vous répéter.
All members within the family would be arrested. Young children,
babies,
older
bébés,
people, everyone
seniors,
from the within the family were arrested.
On arrêtait tout le monde.
Well, I'm not sure if the word arrest is a good word now, but did you see the actual arrest of Rin? Did you see Rin being taken out of his house?
Avez-vous vu que l'on a sorti Rin de sa maison?
Answer, I witnessed that.
J'en ai été
I can vouch for that.
Je le garantis.
Rin was a Jam person. He was within the fisherfolk group.
Il faisait partie du groupe.
Jam person would be included in the
Et
fishing group together with Khmer people. I was on the boat with him. While he was being arrested,
Quand
I was assigned to climb up the sugar palm tree. During that time, he told me where would he be invited to. I replied that I did not know at that time. During that time, I did not realize that he was arrested and sent to the pagoda. After he had been walked past the kitchen, I understood that he was taken into the pagoda. If you asked me back during that period, I could draw
si
a picture of him and what happened to him. Rin's house was close to the fence of the pagoda, and his house is still standing today. You can go and see.
Elle est toujours là aujourd'hui, sa maison. Vous pouvez aller voir.
And Jam people later on were transferred to live in Sambumia.
Ensuite, plus tard, les Cham ont été transférés à Sambumia.
Thank you. It is now time for the break. The chamber will take a short break from now until 3 p.m. Please find a proper room for this witness during the break time, and please invite him back into the courtroom at 3 p.m. The court is now in recess.